All right, everyone. So welcome to the latest Albert's List webinar, Pursuing a Digital Marketing Career with Richard Lowe. And so today we're going to talk about why digital marketing is a career that all professionals, whether you're working in already or whether you're somebody who is about to graduate or thinking about changing your major into something that, you know, has a lot of lasting power. And so my name is Albert Chen. I am the founder of Albert's List, a digital marketer, product marketing manager, hybrid myself. And Albert's List, for those of you who have not been here before, is a job search marketplace bringing together job seekers, recruiters, and career service professionals, such as Richard here, who help bring more value to everyone's career search. And so a little bit about Richard. Richard is the co-founder and CEO of PreHack with his other co-founder, Kathleen Barreto. He's responsible for getting the company's vision and day-to-day operations. He is obsessed with lifelong learning and has created PreHack's Do, Learn, Do way of learning. He's a proud Stanford alum, and he loves cooking. PreHack is an immersive digital marketing training program where in 4 weeks, attendees and students learn the most relevant digital marketing skills from industry experts and get hands-on experience by working on real-world projects. Their next class starts on February 1st, and you can learn more about them at http://prehack.co. That's, once again, the website is prehack.co. So thank you for joining us today, Richard. Happy to have you on the show.
Thanks for having me, Albert. Really excited
and
for this.
Yeah, me as well. I'm really excited to learn more about digital marketing. I've worked here in this industry for a while, and I'm curious to hear more about your perspective today on this show. And for those of you who have also just joined us, feel free to ask questions during the duration of this show. We will answer them, and we will look, and we will just have a free-flowing conversation and go from there. Wonderful. So my first question for you today, Richard, so for everyone who may be working in different industries, who might be thinking about what to major in, or just maybe has never even thought about how marketing affects their day-to-day lives, what on earth is digital marketing?
Definitely. So I think like digital marketing is really the evolution of marketing. And so if you think about any product or service that you experience as a consumer, the things that we buy, you know, from clothing or cars or jewelry, computers, anything that you buy, really there is a marketer on the other side who's selling that service or marketing that service or product to you. And really the digital aspect simply means like these marketing activities are done over the internet or some sort of technology device. Basically, past decade or so, a lot of crazy things have been happening with the emergence of the internet and so many new channels like social media. You've got Google, you've got all of these different ways to reach consumers now. Very, very different from the past where we basically had TV, radio, and print advertising to reach consumers.
So the best way to probably describe this is sort of like a multi-channel approach to all sorts of different marketing platforms. And so if I'm someone that, say, grew up, maybe like using Facebook or just tweeting off my phone, does that make me a digital marketer?
I wouldn't call you necessarily a digital marketer. Maybe a digital native is probably a better term. Mm-hmm. Growing up in digital and really understanding or being part of it from that perspective, a digital marketer really uses those tools to market a company's product or service to his audience.
For sure. Okay. And so as we then look more into, as digital marketing becomes a more and more important skill, what I realized and what you probably teach your students on a day-to-day basis is that because there's so many channels, there's also so many skills involved. So the first half of this question is, how does somebody who maybe loves to hang out on Twitter as a digital native, sends Snapchats and enjoys doing Periscopes for fun to their audience of thousands of thousands, know that digital marketing can be for them?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think that's it's actually a really interesting idea, right? The idea that any individual today can create their own brand and, you know, get their own following on these social media platforms. You mentioned thousands of followers, whether it be on Twitter, any of these platforms. Like, a lot of these people, like, if you are spending that much time on these platforms and, you know, building up such a large audience, you are marketing. In fact, you're just marketing yourself, right? Whether you are a thought leader in the industry and you're marketing your thoughts, or if you're marketing, like, basically, like, any content that you're really proud of, you know, like how-to videos or just images, like pictures that you're taking, this kind of stuff. So I think that that's a really good first step. And so the basic idea would be, okay, if you really like doing that for yourself, then you can take these same skills and translate them and basically do the same thing for a business.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And even if you're like, I guess to go with what, you know, Lee Lin just asked here, what about like, even if you're a digital native who loves to do Snapchat and Facebook and Twitter, all that stuff, how does that even qualify you for a job? Like, how do you know that you can hire that person right out of school to manage your Facebook when it's so visible?
Totally. Yeah. I think the advantage of hiring a person like that is that they know the conventions and the norms of that network, right? There are certain things and certain ways of saying things on, say, like Facebook, that's different from Twitter, which if you didn't grow up on these platforms, then you wouldn't really know. You're just like, oh, all that social networking stuff is all the same, right? But right. In fact, if you actually have used it before, then you know that they're very, very different. And the way that you communicate on each platform is going to be different. So I think that hiring a digital native for these roles, like, is going to give you an advantage. Now, the tricky thing is there's a lot of people who can be users of this platform, but not necessarily thinking the strategic level as a marketer of how do you want to position your own brand or products using these channels, right? So it's really taking these digital natives, giving them some training, or taking these digital natives and, you know, they initiate their own projects to get experience on how to think strategically from a marketing perspective. That's how I would think about it.
And what if I'm a little older? If I'm like in my 30s, maybe my early 40s, and I'm looking for that career transition out, the same idea applies, right? Like, how would I try to convince someone that even though I'm not young and hip and tweeting all day, that digital marketing and social media is something that I can do?
Yeah, I would first start by acquainting myself with these platforms. So really picking the platforms that make sense for, I mean, let's imagine that, you know, I'm midway in my career, I'm a marketer at a company, and I want to stay in the company and I want to switch, say, to the digital team or do more work in social media. The way I would think about it is, okay, firstly, I personally want to get more experience and exposure to these platforms. So I'd build my own profiles on Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, whatever it is. And I'd start personally using it just as an individual user, just to kind of get the feel of like, okay, this is the kind of stuff that's popular and okay to say on Twitter, and this is the kind of stuff that's done in Pinterest and et cetera, right? And then I would just say like, hey, like I can do this, and really show that you have, I think marketers today, the best way to stand out is really to think strategically around like, what is our business objective and what do we need to do to get there? And then secondly, being able to say, okay, with the strategy, like I'm willing to, you know, get my hands dirty and actually execute as well. So that could be writing social media posts on behalf of the company, rather than saying, "Oh, I can do the strategy, but I'll just go hire some 23-year-old digital native to actually write the post." I think that's how a person probably midway in their career can really stand out.
Yeah, definitely. And so my other question then, I guess, you know, the third level question is, so if I'm like a philosophy major, or if I'm like a chemistry major, or if I'm like any other major that's not business marketing or communications, what about entering into digital marketing from that perspective? How does that work within everything? Like if I'm an economics or a mathematics major?
Totally. So the way I would think about digital marketing is, it's a lot of pieces, but no individual piece is actually that complex or difficult to comprehend. So, you know, coming from a marketing background or a communication background, if you study that in school, you're going to get a lot of really good basic, like you have a really strong base of like marketing theory, branding, all of these concepts. But like, as we've said, you know, the whole landscape has been evolving so much in digital marketing, like so many new fields essentially are coming out of it that coming from other industries or from other disciplines, if you study like psychology, for example, you can take a lot of those lessons from psychology and apply them in this mm-hmm. context as well. If you're writing copy for your users, like, you know, you have all these different types of appeals that you can use and to be persuasive. If you're coming from something like economics or mathematics, you know, it may not be directly related, but, you know, I don't think learning these things is, you know, that hard. It's just a matter of dedicating the time and effort to actually learning it mm-hmm. and practicing it is really the key. And just knowing that there's a lot of things and digital marketing is always evolving, right? So what you learn, what I'm going to teach you today is not what I'm going to teach you in 6 months or a year, because, you know, new platforms, new social networks pop up, new ways of communicating pop up. And so marketers have to always be adapting to those new technologies. Not to mention mm-hmm. that we're marketing towards people, right? So mm-hmm. people's preferences change all the time. And so that's kind of the fun part of marketing, which I would say, like, you know, it's great because you're trying to focus on an ever moving target, right? It's not, it's mm-hmm. different from, you know, maybe some other sciences where it's like, you need to just optimize the system and there's like an optimal answer, right? For marketing or anything that has to deal with people, like there's an optimal answer perhaps for now, given the resources now, but tomorrow, 3 months, 6 months from now, it's going to change.
Definitely. So then, because the skills keep on changing, what are some of the fundamentals of digital marketing skills that you think set one digital marketing away from another, digital marketer from away from another? And yeah, I mean, I guess 30 plus mom has a question here. We'll get to that right after we answer this one with regards to fundamental skills.
Okay. Yeah, I think there's a couple of things. So firstly, I think in order to succeed in marketing, you want to be able to balance like having both like a very creative mindset and then also a very analytical mindset. And so what that means is, so for example, let's think about a Facebook advertising campaign, let's say, and I want to create a handful of Facebook ads that target my customers, and my business is selling smartphone cases, for example, right? So on the creative side, I should be able to really think creatively around, what does my customer want? Why would they be interested in buying these cases? And what are the different use cases for them? What features are really important to them, right? And then coming mm-hmm. up with crafting like various advertisements, you know, with Facebook particularly, you can think about different image backgrounds that you can use, or you can think about what's the copy that you're gonna have, or what's the call to action? Does it have to be a discount, or is it just learn more? You have to think about all these different things and basically come up with a bunch of options, right? And we can have intuition around what we think will do well and what we don't think will do well. But at the end of the day, a lot of these things is kind of come up with your best, you know, 3 to 5 options, and then just let's run it, let's test it. And so mm-hmm. then you have to put, that's your
creative. So there's a lot of success and failure in it too then.
Exactly. Yeah. Then you have to put your analytical hat on and say, okay, which ones did well? All right, let's double down on those and just keep going there and then keep branching out.
And you also need to understand a little bit of traditional marketing into it too, and product marketing, which, you know, is what I've been doing for the last 2 years roughly, is mm-hmm. adding that on top of my digital marketing stack to really be able to learn how to do everything from messaging to marketing strategy to everything in between. And so how would you look at somebody maybe who was like, who's like, you know, I've been in like social digital marketing for a while, but also need to learn how to market something like the regular people can. So I guess, you know, that's also another skill and aspect that people need to get in on. What do you think about that?
Sorry, could you repeat the question? Didn't really understand.
So I think what I was saying was that that in a lot of ways you have the traditional and you have now the digital marketing mm-hmm. stack, and mm-hmm. having one or another is fine, but having both is important. Do you think it's important to have, I think, both stacks as well, or absolutely. Just, you know, one going on, both 100%. As well?
I think like each one individually it's okay. Like you said, you can be good, but I think in order to be great, you want to combine both, because while, you know, a lot of the channels and platforms that we're using today are digital, a lot of the concepts and fundamentals that, you know, marketers for hundreds of years came up with, those still apply, right? Those are like fundamental key concepts that still matter. So I think that really to succeed today, you need to be able to balance both.
Most definitely. Most definitely. So attendees who are watching this, if you have any additional questions, please feel free to ask. So let's jump in then into some specific digital marketing careers that people can take on. So what are some of the most popular roles, and what are some of the roles that people may not consider doing and could consider doing?
Sorry, could you repeat the beginning of that? You froze for a second.
Oh, yeah. So I wanted to ask, what are some of the most popular digital marketing careers out there right now? And what are maybe some of the more hidden ones that people have not considered that can both make them a lot of money and pay a huge dividends down the line?
Totally. Yeah, I think right now in digital marketing, it's a lot is around social media, a lot is around email marketing. I think those are probably top couple ones right now, and content marketing as well. I think that the way I think about digital marketing and the successful digital marketer is kind of what we call a T shape. So if you think about like a capital T, at the top you have a wide breadth of marketing knowledge and all the different disciplines, right? So in digital marketing, just to name a few of the topics, we have search engine optimization, so getting your website found on Google. We have social media, we have email marketing, we have analytics. So there's a series of topics. And what we're starting to see is that each topic individually, you can go deep and be an expert in that, right? And what I'm seeing with the best digital marketers that I know really have a good understanding of how all the pieces fit together, like how do these things work together? And then secondly, they typically choose one or more, but at least one discipline just to go really deep in. So that can be email marketing, that can be content marketing. I think a new field in terms of the opportunities that people aren't really seeing yet, and also the business context is it's evolving, is this idea of inbound marketing. And a company called HubSpot really like pushed this. But the basic idea is, instead of thinking about marketing as advertising, where we're creating billboards and we're creating ads and sticking them in front of people's faces and really interrupting our flow, what you do instead is you provide so much value that people are interested in reading that content and engaging with it, and you bring them in that way, and then eventually they'll turn into a customer.
As a holder of the HubSpot inbound marketing certificate and a big fan of what HubSpot does, I can say that that inbound marketing is very important to the process, because I actually do believe that it brings the entire process of digital marketing together, whether it's campaigns, whether it's creating your landing pages, your thank you pages, your email list. You're pretty much doing the end-to-end of it all.
Yep, totally.
I guess what I'm wondering next is companies that are looking for digital marketing people. What kind of companies do you think hire digital marketers the most, and where can people find resources like that to get hired in those kind of roles?
Definitely. So I think the good news is all companies, if they aren't hiring digital marketers right now, they will very soon. And we're seeing that, we're seeing this trend with many, many types of companies, whether they be agencies, huge companies, like retail companies, fashion retail companies, even startups, right? In fact, a lot of startups only focus their efforts on digital. So what I would suggest is really figuring out what kind of product or service you as an individual want to market, right? Yep. Do you want to market software tools for businesses to use, or do you find that boring and you want to market, you know, cars or, you know, clothing? You know, really first figuring out what's the type of product or service that you really resonate with, and then figuring out, okay, who are the big players in that space, and then looking for opportunities that way. And then in terms of ways to find opportunities, I have a lot of experience with startups. So there's a website called Angel List. I think it's angel.co. That has a lot of listings for opportunities at startups specifically. But let me think. So I think there are just tons of also job boards that you can, I would probably just go to Google, honestly, to find a lot of these opportunities.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of using everything from getting your LinkedIn premium up to Indeed to ZipRecruiter to Monster to Career Builder to, you know, just asking your network and seeing what is available. Definitely. So we actually have some questions coming in, which is really great.
Cool.
So Lee Lin asks, what are your thoughts? Is it easier to get in the company first or is it easier to get an education on the topic? So I guess I'm going to go ahead and answer first because I have done a little bit of this before. My opinion on this subject, and you can corroborate or disagree, is that I think it's easier to get the education first because a lot of digital marketing can be acquired in a very, very low cost way. If you know how to noodle your way around like websites like Medium and, you know, figuring out how to do Twitter growth hack strategies to blogging and, you know, creating your own website using an easy to use website like WordPress or Squarespace, you can get pretty, you can start off pretty simply with it. The company, on the other hand, is a lot more difficult because they got to like you, right? So maybe you blog about a certain topic, whether it's technology, or you can be a mini HubSpot and blog about nothing but social media all day. And then you go out and you build that audience, and then you prove concept to your employer that is trying to hire you that, hey, look, I built this entire 6,000 follower Twitter account all by myself, blogging on Tumblr, which is actually how I started my career way back when. And Tumblr is actually really great for this because you get out, you automatically show up in the feeds of other people and people can follow you and they reblog you and it's really frictionless. And then you show your prowess for multi-channel marketing by sharing your stuff to LinkedIn, by reposting on LinkedIn, Medium, Facebook, and all over the place. And you stick something in your signature and then you see the traffic roll in. And in some cases, you might end up working for a company where your personal website has more traffic than their website. And so they got to hire you to figure out how to like grow their traffic as well. Yeah. So that's kind of my thought. If you have a little bit of money, you know, it never hurts to run a Facebook ad here or there. You can actually do quite a bit with $5. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you have.
I definitely agree with that. I think digital marketing is really unique because people often fall into the trap of thinking, how am I going to get any experience unless someone offers me a job to get experience? But in fact, like we talked about earlier, and exactly what you mentioned, you can create your own experience by treating yourself as the product that you're marketing, right? Another interesting way of getting experience in order to get a job that I've seen a lot of people do is volunteer. So you can volunteer for a small business and help them get their business online. One of our friends did that with a restaurant. It was a local sushi restaurant. She said, hey, like, I want to get into marketing. Can I help you get your online presence going? So she set up an Instagram account, a Yelp account, helped them set up their website. She figured all this out on the fly. And that was enough experience for her to get her first job. So I would definitely say in terms of, you know, judging between the two, like, should I go learn first or should I get the job first? I think what you'll find when you start reaching out to employers and applying is a lot of people are asking you to have some sort of experience beforehand. And I think the best way...
I think they also want you to know that you can just talk about it, right? Mm-hmm. Like, for example, I don't have any Google AdWords experience, mm-hmm. but at the very end of the day, if you're able to talk about long tail keywords and short tail keywords and being able to bid things up and bid things down, then that's pretty much what AdWords is at the end of the day.
Yep.
AdSense, you know, I don't really have that much experience with that either. That's being able to put ads on your Google, on your website that will drive advertising revenue. Mm-hmm. SEO, I don't have much experience with that, but it's the ability to place in keywords in your meta tags that drive website traffic. So, you know, I mean, some companies will be anal about it and they'll be like, oh, we want, you know, 10 years of SEO experience. But most companies, as I keep looking on job boards, as I'm, you know, back on the market now, are like, yeah, you know, working knowledge of whatever. And if you're able to like talk about it a little bit, then, you know, you can do okay with it. Mm-hmm. At least that's how I see it.
Yep.
Yeah. So going back up and looking at more questions here, Anushri asks, for someone who wants to start a career in digital marketing, how do I go about prepping for it, considering digital marketing is a broad subject? Well, I think we answered that in the last little bit. So I would actually, you know, I mean, if you're going to choose, content marketing is the easiest way to begin. My suggestion is to get started on LinkedIn Pulse if you don't know how to build your own website, and start blogging about a topic that you're passionate about, whether it's the career that you want to go into, whether it's the vertical that you want to work in, and or if it's a specific skill. So, you know, you could write a lot about SEO if you wanted to. It's, you know, it's sexy to the very specific crowd, but, you know, that's one way to get in on it. And if you can build that kind of traffic up, then it's pretty good for yourself. And if you can make money from it, it's even better, but you don't necessarily need to have that as a prerequisite, but it's really attractive. Yeah. Let's see. How attractive would a recruiter find a profile of a digital marketer with multiple online certifications from HubSpot or Coursera versus a degree in digital marketing? So after hours 88, I think my answer to that, and Richard can answer. Actually, I'll let Richard answer first because this is his interview and I don't want to take over his conversation.
No worries. No, I love the way you're answering. Yeah, certifications I think are fine, but at the end of the day, they're going to ask you real questions around how would you think about our business and how would you think about the marketing on what we need to do, right? It's like, because as an employer, it's what value can you offer me? And in exchange, I'm going to offer you this thing that we call employment, which has a paycheck and et cetera. Right. So I think that certifications are good signaling things, but at the end of the day, you should really be focused on understanding digital marketing and figuring out how you can offer value to the companies, whether that be through these formal courses and getting certificates, or if it's doing your own stuff or your own research or your own projects, whatever it is. What do you have to add, Albert?
Yeah. Okay. You know, I would actually add the same thing. Like I think the most important thing that I've learned in my career so far with a marketing perspective is the more strategic you're able to think, the better off you are. Mm-hmm. Very early on in my career, in a very long, long time ago, when I was far more naive than I am now, the idea of working in social media was appealing to me because I could spend all day on Facebook. But a manager very early on kind of stopped my tracks there and was like, you got to think strategically. And ultimately, you know, I didn't last at that job because I didn't get it. But, you know, now that it's been several years since, I sound like my manager. Every marketing activity you do has to be a strategic activity. Otherwise, you're wasting budget and you're wasting dollars, because marketing dollars are very, very hard to come by. And you have to be able to communicate, and you have to be able to deliver the value proposition of what good marketing is. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think in my opinion, it's either or is okay. Having another certification won't hurt you, but it won't help you if you can't think strategically and can't think like how you want to add to the business's bottom line. And that's ultimately why we work for the companies we work for the most part, because we're looking to assist companies in helping reach their revenue goals. And if you're not there to help your companies reach their revenue goals, they have no reason to retain you. That's just the simple truth of it. That's, you know, real life.
Yeah, gotta pay the bills.
You got to keep the lights on. Yeah. So the other question is, how can you brand yourself as a digital marketing expert? Should I have an official social media management business? So this is a question that I've heard a lot of answers to over the last 4 years. Number one, the first and only rule you need to know about this answer is there is no such thing as a digital marketing expert, because digital marketing and social media is changing so often and so quickly that to consider yourself an expert would kind of be foolish. At the end of the day, right? I mean, you can have people who are experts on whales. You can have people who are experts on building skyscrapers, and experts on people who want to talk about the history of China. Those things are established. Those things are tried. Those things are true. Those things can't really be disproven. But digital marketing is an art and a science and I want to actually have you talk about this art and science aspect, because I think that's another part that I've heard questions about before too, mm-hmm. When it comes to digital marketing, the art of it is being able to write and being able to tell the story, and the science of it is being able to measure it. And because the art and the science are always evolving and always changing, calling yourself an expert doesn't really hold weight. Like if I see you add me on LinkedIn and your headline is digital marketing expert, I'm probably going to hit no, and I'm probably not going to want to connect with you because I'm probably going to get a sales pitch. So what are your thoughts on all of that?
Yeah, I completely agree. I think trying to say that you're a digital marketing expert is a bit foolish because everything's changing. It's like you can be the expert now. Sure, you're the expert right now.
Yeah.
But tomorrow you're not the expert anymore. I think maybe the deeper meaning of the question, I'm just reading into it a bit, mm-hmm. is like, sure. How can you position yourself as perhaps a thought leader, maybe we should call it that, in digital marketing? And I think something like that could be simply sharing, like, you know, the lower touch side, like sharing really relevant content that you find really interesting and valuable as you think is the cutting edge of digital marketing. And then taking the next mm-hmm. step of creating your own content, because as you experiment and as you get more experience in digital marketing yourself, you're going to come up with these different insights and viewpoints, right? Because the thing about digital marketing is this tactic may work for one business and one vertical, but it mm-hmm. doesn't always apply to every business, right? So
no.
There's always lessons to learn.
Past success is not a guarantee of future results.
Absolutely.
It's with your stock market, it's with your stocks, and it's with, you know, your digital marketing.
Absolutely.
So then I guess, if there is no such thing as a digital marketing expert and personal branding is kind of that arena where you got to consider yourself the expert, how does one brand themselves as a digital marketer? What do you do? I mean, what do you say? I mean, I know that Sherry, you know, puts herself as a digital marketing aficionada mm-hmm. on her LinkedIn, mm-hmm. which is really cool. I like that. And I mean, I just list my skills just because that's what I put up there. But yeah, I mean, what do you say and what do you do and how do you communicate yourself?
Sorry, Albert.
To where you don't sound. Oh, sorry. Am I cutting out here?
Yeah, I think you froze or I froze for a sec. Could you repeat what you were saying?
Yeah, how do you brand yourself as a digital marketer when traditionally in the concept of branding, you're supposed to position yourself as a leader, and because there's really nothing that leads on digital marketing. I mean, there's memorable, you know, there's things that are memorable. That's why I know what Sherry's headline is. But, you know, how do you position yourself as somebody who's memorable and somebody that's hireable as well?
Totally.
What can you put in your LinkedIn profile? What can you say?
Right. I think so. Okay, it's kind of like untie this question. So the first thing is, I think, right. Firstly, we need to be clear that it's not like digital marketing has a finite number of things to learn, like 10 things to learn, and then you're done. And you're the expert, right? It's always changing, so there's always things to learn. So I think if we assume that, then becoming a digital marketer.
I mean, I can't be the all-encompassing digital marketing guru that knows every single thing.
Well, if you figure that out, you let me know, and I want to be that too.
You let me know too. I don't know the answer to that any better than you do.
Sure. So what I would say is, like, really, you want to position yourself as thinking about what's happening in digital marketing, like staying on top of the trends and the new waves, the new technologies that are popping up. Mm-hmm. You know, if a new technology pops up and it gets really popular, like you want to be on top of that and have an opinion, right? I think that is one mm-hmm. thing that I've learned. Always having an opinion. It doesn't have to be right, right? But like, you know, taking a stance on something really positions you in, like, really, I don't know, gives you a certain position to say, I believe in this. And that's a really compelling mm-hmm. thing to say. So in terms of, you know, what to put on your LinkedIn, you know, I would firstly try to get as much experience or learn about as many things as I can. And then really just put the facts on my LinkedIn, right? Like any experience, like if you started building up your Twitter following or your Tumblr blog, like talk about that, mm-hmm. talk about interesting things that you've done, because in the interview, that's what people want to hear about at the end of the day. Okay, you might be 23, you might have just graduated from college, you may have not had a job before, but why should I hire you for this social media role? And then you go, well, hey, I started this I, you know, whatever, participated in this race and I wanted to get more people to hear about it. So I said, I'm going to take ownership of this. I volunteered and I increased our followers from 500 to 2000 in 6 months or whatever it was, you know, by doing X, Y, Z. We got people to use these hashtags, take photos, share them, get everyone to like them. And that's what an employer wants to hear, right? Like for me, if I were looking for
someone
to hire, it's like, that's what I want. I need someone who can think strategically for my business, right?
Yep. 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 Makes sense. Makes sense. And I mean, yeah, I mean, that's how I got into it. And, you know, that's how I continue it. Like that's what building Albert's List for my own career was in addition to this. So, you know, it really helps really well. So the next question I want to answer, I want to get into is, and I know Jack Murdoch, I see you not, or Eric, I see your question over there, and we'll get it there. We'll get to that in a really quick moment. But I want to actually cover off on digital marketing pay because, you know, hey, I love doing marketing, but if you're not going to give me a paycheck every 2 weeks, should I come work for you? And if I work for you, can I pay my rent, especially in the Bay Area where it's like, what is it like $3,000 for a bathroom now?
Yeah, if that. Yeah, cardboard boxes are going on sale.
Oh my goodness, cardboard boxes for $600 a month. Roof not guaranteed.
For sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, about pay. Let's talk about that.
Yeah. So I think it really, you know, there's no really easy answer here because it's going to depend on industry, the company, the stage of the company where they're at. Like if you're going to go work for a startup, say, and you know it's pre-seed or early days in their fundraising rounds, they may just not have so much budget. I think for entry-level marketing roles, like if we want to talk about numbers, what I've seen often is between like the 30 to 60K range annual salary. But that's like not including any comp or any of the other benefits. But this is like obviously a pretty big range. And what I would really recommend is identifying the types of companies that you wanted to work for and then going to a site like Glassdoor and figuring out what are the averages for the starting positions that you're interested in, whether they be social media or any of the other roles.
So you just scared me there by saying 30 to 60K range.
Yep.
Who's doing digital marketing in the Bay Area on 30K a year?
Yeah.
Besides like an intern.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it really depends, yeah. Like I said, like it like when we talk to people around people who are looking for opportunities and also even companies hiring, it's just so spread. It's really hard to say. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, my first job in the Bay was 32K a year working on Salesforce-related technologies, thankfully. And yeah, actually back as late as like 2012, you know, I made 44K a year doing enterprise collaboration. So, you know, there is that. That's you do it for the experience, that's for sure.
Definitely.
And so to answer I Am Jack Murdoch's question, is digital marketing, we talked about like majoring in it and getting into it. So what does an entry level digital marketing role look like? And how does one maybe get into that? Because I know that in today's world, you've got so many kids competing for so many different jobs that looking for a job is like almost a headache in itself.
For sure.
And so thankfully, you know, I'm glad that even though I'm on this job search, I'm now 5 years into the experience. And so I have that experience leg up, which doesn't mean I have to like fight for everything.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think a lot of,
what about entry level?
Yeah. A lot of entry level roles typically will start in, you know, going back to that T-shaped model, will typically start in one of those disciplines. So you might be like an SEO specialist or a social media specialist, basically focus on a very specific vertical. And so that's kind of where it probably makes sense before you jump right in to figure out where you want to play and learn, at least do some research around the top of the T and figuring out what are the different aspects of digital marketing, what are the different types of roles that I could get into, and then focusing on, okay, hey, social media is something that I really want to learn more about. Let me go join a company as that role. I think that's what you'll typically find for entry-level roles. But as soon as you get out of the entry-level role and you're looking to, say, you know, get to a manager role, then you want to broaden your scope and learn a little bit more about everything to see what makes sense for the business and think more strategically. Yeah.
That makes sense. So, you know, we're heading up into, I think, the 40-minute mark of this. And so I know that you run a program, PreHack, along with Kathleen Barreto. Mm-hmm. And I know that we usually leave the last 10 minutes for our guests to promote whatever they want. But because you have a program that's actually a little longer than what maybe you could explain in 10 minutes, I'm curious to hear, like, when it comes to teaching digital marketing in the marketplace in your classrooms, mm-hmm. what are your students learning and what are the value propositions that they can expect to come away with during this 4-week experience with you?
Yeah, absolutely. So basically we have a 4-week full-time program where in terms of the T-shaped model, what we do is we give experience, we give people hands-on experience through projects of all the different aspects of digital marketing, or not all, but a lot of them. And basically how that works is we use this model called Do, Learn, Do, where basically each topic we break it down into an exercise. So for SEO, it would be coming up with keywords for your website. For social media, it's actually creating Facebook advertisements. For content marketing, it would be actually coming up with a blog and creating content for that blog. So you got to get the idea of, like, you can get through our program, the idea is that you get a taste for everything. And then at the end of it, you'd be able to say, okay, cool, I really liked content marketing, or I really liked social media. I want to get my first job in that specific vertical. And then go deep. So we're training the top of the T, and then after PreHack, you could go and go focus and, you know, develop your expertise in the bottom of the T.
So what are some, and if it's secret knowledge, what are some things that I can learn if I join in on PreHack? So is it like SEO, social media, mm-hmm. blogging, inbound, all of that stuff, or mm-hmm. yeah. what can the usual person expect to learn?
Yeah, absolutely. So we start out the course with an introduction to the marketing funnel. So it's this concept that, mm-hmm. you know, basically we want to attract, you know, get in front of a really wide audience and then keep, you know, pulling them in. But at each level, the audience kind of funnels down until you can turn them into an actual customer. So that's kind of the framework, the most important model that you need to learn in digital marketing. And then we teach you a series of topics that go through it. So you'll learn about SEO, you'll learn about content marketing. So coming up with your one true fan and who you're actually focusing mm-hmm. your product or services mm-hmm. for, and thinking and brainstorming, creating value for that person. So it can be blog content, it can be videos, it can be, you know, PDF downloads. It can be, you know, if we're helping job seekers, then it could be like resume templates or cold mm-hmm. email templates, things like this. And then we also have topics like email marketing. So for example, once you have someone who's read your blog and signed up for your mailing list, how do you keep emailing them and, you know, reminding them, like, hey, we're still here, we're still offering you value, and you can keep bringing them in closer and closer to the end of the funnel where they actually turn into a customer. So you learn and then we also have a topic around analytics. So how do you measure mm-hmm. all these things? You know, we get our hands a little bit dirty in Google Analytics to figure out, okay, how many people are coming to my blog? How long are they staying? Of the people who come to this mm-hmm. one blog post, how many of them are leaving? You know, what's the bounce rate? So you kind of get a little bit of understanding of, like, how these things work. And that's really the value that we're offering. I think a lot of people who have no experience with digital marketing don't even know where to start. They don't know how to think about it, right? And PreHack is mm-hmm. a really quick, you know, it's a month long, but it's like a lot of learning in just 1 month. So it's a very efficient way of getting it done.
Yeah, because, I mean, you can get Google Analytics certified, I believe, too. Yeah. So it's like you can pick up a lot of it in just a week, and you can do social media in just a week, yep. and you can do all the content stuff in just a week. Yep. Then, you know, I think there's definitely a lot of potential out of it. For those of you in the audience, if you have any other questions, we're going to keep going here. We have about 16 to 17 minutes left on the usual time frame here. So what are some really interesting, like, digital marketing trends that you think we'll be hitting as we head into 26, as we head, well, deeper into 2016?
Yeah, so
for this year,
I think inbound is going to become more and more popular. Inbound, the mm-hmm. whole concept of offering value to your customers and bringing them, having them come to you rather you going out and spending money and plastering ads everywhere. I think that a lot more companies are going to start catching on to this idea. And the nice thing about it is when you're creating content, like, sure, it costs some money up front, but that content can last forever, right? Your blog posts are still published, your videos are still there. Very different from paying for advertising and getting some customers that way. But as soon as you stop paying for advertising, you get no customers, right? So I think companies are going to start thinking about, oh, wow, this is a very highly leveraged way, if you will, or a really good bang for your buck in terms of marketing activities. I think that's one really important trend that's probably going to be pretty big this year.
My opinion on that is just that, like, just to come in real quick, is that, marketing is probably the one business activity that doesn't have a system that's really in place, because, you know, for a long time, it's create a content calendar, post stuff. If something, you know, crazy or disastrous or a holiday happens, you know, post something then. If nothing happens at that point, then, you know, whatever, it's cool. However, I think, like, as it's gone on, there's been this need for a system. And I feel like inbound marketing might be that system that that ultimately changes things. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And evergreen content definitely does it too, because I feel like at the end of the day, people just don't have the time to write, you know, 5 reasons you should buy chocolate on Valentine's Day for, you know, 10 years in a row. Totally. It just doesn't do you any good anymore. And so you want to drive traffic back to what it is that, you know, you're doing. And at that point, you know, it'll be a lot better. So, but what were your other ideas as far as what will happen this year in 2016 in digital marketing?
Yeah, I think the second thing that's going to be really big is a lot of efforts around, I think we're going to see a lot of really interesting things happen around app store optimization. So mobile apps are obviously a huge thing. And these app companies are trying to find very cost-effective ways of getting new users to download their app. So I'm really excited and interested to see what happens on that front. Google just released a new universal app campaign, I think is what they call it, system, which basically allows you as a company who builds an app to create an advertisement using Google's resources or using Google's templates. Google will automatically test it on all of its platforms, Google Plus, YouTube, search, whatever it is, based on your budget. And figure out, okay, if it's starting to do really well on YouTube, it's going to double down and optimize your portfolio accordingly. So I think we're going to see so many more things around app store optimization, because it's kind of like the new frontier. Mobile apps specifically is the new frontier that is really untapped, and it's exciting. So I'm really curious to see what happens on that front.
Yeah, I think that as we head into 2016 and we see a lot of people looking to, we'll see a lot of partnerships. I mean, that's what app stores are all about, where you bring people, you bring groups of people together to pretty much, I would say, sell en masse. That's kind of, you know, what my company Ingram Micro is doing with the cloud marketplace. It's what lots of other companies are doing with their own marketplaces, and that's kind of what the app store aspect is. Okay, so 30 Plus Mom asks, what are top conferences to explore and network in the digital marketing space? So I'll let you answer that question, and if you don't cover some events, I'll ask some of my own too. I'll add some of my own.
Conferences. I can't really recommend any at the moment, actually. Albert, if you have any, you can jump in here.
I would say that a couple solid ones include South by Southwest coming up in March. It's, in my opinion, kind of reached a bit of a peak since the launch of Foursquare in 2009, but that's generally pretty good. If you want to go straight up social media, the social media, what is it called? The Michael Stelzner of the Social Media Examiner has the Social Media Managers Conference every single year in April in San Diego. So that's pretty good too. If you're in the Bay Area, there's a lot of different digital marketing groups that you can join. A lot of them are unfortunately in San Francisco, but that's where you'll find a lot of them. And you can occasionally go to the occasional startup event that also talks about how startups can succeed over social media as well. And then, you know, there's a lot of Facebook groups out there that have the digital focus too. whether it's social media managers or, you know, any of the other hundreds of them out there. I guess my other question then, now that we're heading right into our last 10 minutes, is what about social media celebrities? Who do you follow on social media that is really good and worth following because, you know, they know what they're talking about and they are the cream of the crop? Do you have any suggestions on that side?
I've been following Neil Patel a lot. Mm-hmm. So I really like his stuff. And most recently, there's this guy named David Ocker. He's kind of really famous in the whole branding side of things. But I've been, as we talked about earlier, combining the whole digital plus the, you know, the old school, if you will, or traditional marketing or marketing fundamentals, that I've been really interested in a lot of the stuff that he's been putting out. Other people that I follow, actually not really people, but I think Buffer's content is awesome. Also HubSpot, their content's great as well. So I'd probably recommend those.
Yeah, Buffer does do one of the better blogs out there, mm-hmm. as far as social digital is concerned.
Yep.
And so, you know, you can use Buffer for free actually, yep. as a digital marketing person and push content to multiple areas. And They have a version called the Awesome version, which I think you can get for like $8 a month for the entire year. And I use that for my multiple channels and clients and things of that sort. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's really good. Mm-hmm. So we're down to our last 9 minutes, and I know you had a chance to explain what PreHack was a little earlier. Uh-huh. Now I want you to tell people, in addition to why they should consider digital marketing as a career, why they should become digital marketing, not experts, but digital marketing professionals through PreHack. So I'll give you the floor for the next couple of minutes.
Cool, definitely. Yeah, I think, so to answer the first question, why digital marketing as a career? I think it's a very exciting time to be in digital marketing today. Like we said, so many things are changing that there's just so much to be done. So I think it's like, really ripe for picking up like great new opportunities that no one's really discovered yet. So on that front, it's really, really exciting. And why PreHack? I think that PreHack, if you're interested in digital marketing, it's going to be one of the highest value and quickest ways for you to really get your hands deep into digital marketing, really figure out how does all this work, get hands-on experience. So you're building your own portfolio, mm-hmm. around it so that you could show to employers after the program to get a job. That's one value add. The second value add is really being part of a community, right? At PreHack, we really foster a tight-knit community of our students plus our mentors. So all of our classes are the curriculum is designed alongside industry experts. So what we're teaching our students is actually what these experts are using in their work as digital marketers. Mm-hmm. So that's like one thing that we're very different on from traditional school. And like, we don't really have a classroom environment. It's all focused around projects, mm-hmm. you know, and there's not much lecture in what we do. So yeah, I would say
that's good because we don't miss that from college.
Go ahead, sorry?
Lectures. I don't miss lectures from college.
No, not at all. Absolutely not. So yeah. We really believe in a model of doing as the best way of, mm-hmm. of learning.
I agree. And so how can people learn more about your program? What's their process of applying, or is everyone welcome into this program? Everybody gets accepted, or mm-hmm. how does that work?
Yeah, definitely. It's a very good question. So if you're interested in PreHack, you can check us out at prehack.co. So that's PreHack.co. Maybe I'll write it. There we go. Okay.
Yep.
On top of it. You can check us out there. We have information about the program, around the details of what happens. You can also read some blog posts from our first class that we held in November. So hear from our students and hear how the program went for them. In terms of the mm-hmm. selection criteria, so PreHack, one of our unique value propositions is really that we offer really small classes. So we have a maximum of 10 students for each of our classes. So it is,
oh wow,
it is quite selective. We have an application process that involves a fun little, what we call do or do is the way we teach. So it's kind of like do the exercise. Mm-hmm. You realize like this was hard, this was easy, or whatever it is. And then you have the learn session where you actually like get okay, this is how it works in industry, best practices. And then you get a second do where you can say, okay, now that I know, I'm going to do it again. So you have this really great before and after. But in the application process, we've designed it such that you do a mini exercise of do, learn, do, so that you can kind of get a feel for our learning style. And, you know, our learning style is, I think it works for a lot of people, but it may not work for you. So that's, I think it's really important to go to practice. Also, as we were talking earlier around resources, you know, there's a little treat. If you guys sign up for our email list on the website, then the first email we'll send you is a free PDF of just some of the resources that we recommend, some blogs and some books to check out if you're interested in digital marketing.
That's good. I like hearing that. Yeah. And so is PreHack open to anyone and everyone, if whether I'm, you know, 21 and, you know, just got into school or into college or about to leave college, or whether I'm like, you know, 44 and sick of my paper pushing job.
Yeah, definitely. We're open to everyone. I think it really depends on your schedule. So one challenge is it's a 1 month full-time program. So it's difficult to juggle that with a full-time job. We are thinking about, you know, opportunities that we can create for people who are working already. But for this program specifically, the one that we're talking about is a full-time opportunity. And, you know, we don't have any hard requirements. The two things that we're really looking for are people with a passion for digital marketing, that like you're really genuinely interested in it. And you can demonstrate that to us by saying, you go to these events, you're part of these groups, you're learning from these materials online. And secondly, we just want you to have a great attitude, because part of who we are is we're building a community of people, of like-minded people who can really help each other grow, right? So we need great personalities to come join us as well.
Perfect. Perfect. Great. And so if there's any, do you have any parting thoughts for the folks on this webinar today who may who may still be wondering or maybe fully convinced or anyone in between as we end our webinar? And if there's any final questions, put them in here in the next 15 seconds.
Yeah. Definitely.
Otherwise we'll just be ending things.
Definitely.
Yeah.
No, I would say, like, if you're interested at all in digital marketing, like, the resources are available. There's tons of ways for you to get involved. Like, give it a shot, try something. Start reading at the very least, but, you know, if you want to get a little bit more practice, you know, build up your own, market yourself. You know, if you're not comfortable marketing yourself, go find something else that you want to market. But it's just like a really fun exercise. And now's a great time because it's so cheap to get started. You know, as long as you have a computer and internet connection, you're set. So I'd say just go out and do stuff.
Great. All right. So with that, we're going to go ahead and conclude today's webinar. If you've got any interest in what PreHack has to offer, the website is prehack.co. If you're interested in what Albert's List has to offer, the website is albertslist.org or bit.ly/findyournextjob for our Facebook group of almost 12,000 people now. So come back soon for our upcoming webinars. We're going to have a couple here in February, and we'll chat with you all really soon. Thanks for joining.
Thank you.